Aftermarket automotive professionals want to help their customers do what's best for their vehicles. However, that's not so easy when customers cling to myths and misconceptions about auto parts, diagnostics, and vehicles in general. In this video, we're going to bust a few myths about brake pads and rotors. The logic behind them might seem profound, but ultimately these myths make it harder for counter pros and technicians to address common brake problems that their customers might be experiencing. Myth number one, all brake pads are the same. This is false. One of the greatest myths out there is that some customers won't use the full potential of a brake pad due to their driving style or commute. This is false because the one time that the customer needs to use the full potential of the pad, the performance won't be measured in dollars and cents, but rather in inches and feet. If you're not sure about the standards you should have for recommending replacement brake pads, set aside some time to try out the brands that you recommend. Perform at least 4 emergency stops from 55 miles per hour to a dead stop, back to back. Let your right foot be the judge. Myth number two, all rotors are the same. This is false. Even if a rotor fits on a vehicle, it still might not be the right rotor for the vehicle or the driver. Low quality rotors might make sense to the wallet, but if the rotors aren't able to absorb and dissipate heat efficiently, the distance it takes to stop the vehicle can increase. An economy rotor might appear to be nearly identical to a premium quality rotor, but the metallurgy is often much different. There are many different grades of cast iron, and some make much better brake rotors than others. The specific metallurgy affects the sound qualities, the hardness and wear resistance of the rotor, and even its friction characteristics. Myth number three, replacement brake pads are regulated for performance. This is also false. There are no government mandated or industry regulations regarding brake pad performance. Myth number four, brake rotors warp. This is false. Rotors do not warp. In the 1970s, someone came up with the whole warping theory and it stuck. Why? Well, because to the layperson, it makes sense. But in reality, it's a false explanation that doesn't hold up. What's often described as warping is actually the presence of two verifiable phenomena that can be experienced individually or in combination, neither of which have anything to do with warping. These phenomena are brake torque variation and disc thickness variation. Myth number five, wet brake rotors increase stopping distances. So this is true and false. Remember when you were first learning to drive and some adult told you to tap the brake pedal after you drove through a puddle? In the days of drum brakes, this was good advice. But with disc brakes, this piece of advice doesn't hold water, literally. If a vehicle is moving, water is thrown off the face of the rotor by centrifugal force. Any water on the pads is inconsequential. But some vehicles will auto-pulse the brakes to remove water if the rain-sensing wiper system detects water on the windshield. A big thank you to ASE certified technician Andrew Markell for putting this list together. I'm Josh Cable. Thanks for watching.